Good morning students, I am your English teacher Shabana and today's topic is making asking sentences using do and does. In Let's Try 7, you have to make asking sentences using do and does. So first of all, where do we use do and does. And okay students, so students, we use do and does in simple present tense when we have to make asking sentences in simple present tense. Under the simple present tense, then we use do and does in negative sentences and interrogative sentences. So here is your Let's Try 7, and now I am making a table for you. Okay, when we have singular pronouns like he, she, it, okay, and any singular noun like Priya or a child, okay, a child is a singular number, Priya is a singular noun, and he, she, it, these are singular pronouns. When we have he, she, it, Priya, a child, then we use does with the singular subject. These are singular subject, and when we have a singular subject in the sentence, then we have to use does with the singular subject, like he does, he does, she does, it does, Priya does, child does. He does, she does, it does, Priya does, child does. Okay, and then if we have to make an asking sentence in a simple present tense, then we will use it before the subject. Okay, hum subject se pehle isko use karte hain. We will use do and does before the subject. Okay, but before that we will learn where do we use do. Yes, if we have subject, plural subjects in the sentence like I, we, you, they, and any plural subject like children, hai na, like children and Priya and I. Priya and I, these are two person. It means this is a plural subject. Okay, when we have plural subject in the sentence, then we will use do. Okay, then we will use do, like Priya and I do, children do, I do, we do, you do, they. Okay, Priya and I do, children do, I do, we do, you do, they. And if we make an asking sentence using do, then we will put do before the subject. Okay, how? Now I am going to make asking sentences from the statement using do and does. First of all students, we will read the statement. Here is a statement, that is Renu goes to the swimming pool. Renu goes to the swimming pool. This is a sentence of simple present tense. Yes, this is a sentence of simple present tense. So students, I will teach you simple present tense after the next video. But here is the sentence of simple present tense, and now we will learn how to make an asking sentence of simple present tense. Yes, students, when we have a sentence of simple present tense, then we use do and does to make asking sentences of simple present tense. Renu goes to the swimming pool. So here what will we use? Here, yes students, what will we use? Do or does? Yes, I told you if the subject is singular, then we will use does before the subject. If the subject is plural, we use do before the subject. Okay, so where is the subject? Renu. Renu is the subject and Renu is a singular one. Renu is the singular noun. That's why we will use does. Does Renu and now we will write the sentence. We will write the remaining sentence, but we will write the helping verb in first form. How? This is the first form, but we use it. We use go without es. Without does Renu go? Es. We will remove es. Okay, we will remove es in the goes from the goes. Does Renu go to the swimming pool? Yes students, always remember when we make asking sentences in simple present tense and we use do and does in asking sentence. Jab hum use karte hain do and does, then we will have to use the first form of verb instead of es form. Here is the es form in the statement, but when we make the interrogative sentence, when we make an asking sentence, then we will have to put the first form of verb. Okay, does Renu go to the swimming pool? And after that, after ending this sentence, we will have to put a punctuation mark, and that is question mark, because it is an asking sentence, and an asking sentence always ends with a question mark. Okay, now we will do the next one. They have a new handbag. They have a new handbag. Yes students, they have a new handbag. Now we have to make an asking sentence from it. Students, in this sentence we have to recognize the subject. The subject, if the subject is singular, then we will put does. If the subject plural, then we will put do. So they, yes, is the subject plural or singular? Yes, the subject is plural. They is plural. So we will put do. Do they have a new bag? A new handbag. Okay, they have a new bag. Do they have a new bag? Okay, yes. The next one, the neighbors have a dog. The neighbors have a dog. The neighbors have a dog. So recognize the subject. If the subject singular, so if the subject singular, then we will have to put does. If the subject is plural, then we will have to put do before the subject. Okay, this is the subject. The neighbors have a dog. The neighbors have a dog. We are talking about neighbors. This is the subject. So neighbors is the plural. Neighbors is the plural noun, plural subject, and because it is neighbors, hai na? neighbors. It is a plural noun. That's why we will put what? Do before the subject. Do the neighbors have a dog? And the next one, you like the rains. Okay, the subject is plural, you is the plural pronoun, hai na, you is the plural pronoun. So we will for do you like the rains? Okay, now we will read the next one. She buys a book. This is a sentence of simple present tense. She buys a book. And now we will recognize the subject. The subject is she. She is a singular subject. That's why we will use does before subject. Does she? And this one, this is helping verb. And when we use do does in the sentence, then we will have to use the first form of verb in the sentence. So that's why does she buy? We do not use S form with verb. Okay, S form use नहीं करना है, we नहीं करेंगे. We will not use S form with verb. She buys a book. Now we will make the interrogative sentence. This is an asking sentence using the does she buy a book? Okay, next one is he goes to the park. He is a singular pronoun, hai na? That's why we will use does he, and goes is a helping verb, and we do not use s or es form. We use only first form of verb when we use do and does in the sentence. Okay, so does he go to the park? Does he go to the park? The last one, they have a football match today. In this sentence, we have to recognize the subject. They is the plural subject, hai na? They is the plural subject. That's why we will use do. We will use do before they, before this. Do they have a football match today? And put a question mark at the end of the sentence. So student, this is your Let's Try 7. And in this Let's Try 7, you have to make asking sentences using do and does. And I have taught how to use do and does in the sentences. And what are the rules of using the do and does. Okay students, so you have to do this Let's Try 7 in your book. Stay home, keep safe. Bye.